So I'm about to break out one of my ultimate secrets that I don't share with nobody. So you better tell everybody right now. But make sure you watch closely. You watch closely. Watch closely. A lot of times whenever you're wearing a wig, you got all of these short hairs. Always trying to blend them in, blow dry them in, put mousse on them. Listen, if you get rid of them all together, you get the mobility of real hair. It looks like it was made in a factory. Are there any tips you can share that will help the density of the hair in the part look more natural and have a more realistic finish? Density is the word that we use to refer to the amount of hair that's added per hole, right? This is called cutting returns. Return hair is also known as beard hair. It's the hair that's left over when looping hair for ventilation. If you don't know what ventilation is the art where the wig maker ties hair onto a lace base or wig cap. On this before and after diagram, you'll see that when the returns are cut, it allows the hair to be less dense and have a lot more natural movement. This has no returns. Look at how it moves from the scalp. Can you see that? How it moves from the scalp? These don't have the returns cut. And all of the short hairs are, let me show you where the short hairs are. So they're just like really dense and stuck in there, but it's a bunch of those little short hairs, right? Because of that, let's see, does that move the same way? No, not in the scalp and the parting area. All of this moves as a chunk. So if we put a curl there, then all of this gets caught up in a chunk. If we curl right in here, we'll get a more consistent, more realistic curl. So this side here has the returns cut. This side here still has the returns in. You can already see it's a lot thicker at the root. I wish I could hold both at the same time. I'm gonna try to. Let me try to. Oh my gosh, can you see that? Look at that. Can you see the movement in this side? The movement in this side versus the movement in this side? All right, so I'm gonna show you a demo on how to cut the returns. Let me just explain a little bit about what factories do. Most factories, all of the hair is non-Remy hair. Because it's non-Remy, the cuticle, remember, that area where it's non-Remy, all of this right here has a process on it. So over time, you're gonna find that this area is gonna mat and tangle as well. We got two different cuticles going in directions and they're not cut. Always work with great factories, so at least I'm not gonna get 5 inches of return, and that's gonna be hanging all the way down here and just so much weight in the wig, and it kind of camouflages the fact that a lot of wigs are thin. Cutting returns, the most important thing is understanding your wig. So this wig has a little baby hairs in the front, so I don't want to cut that. I want to keep the baby hairs for the wig's sake, but I do want to go right behind the baby hairs and start lifting up to where I find long length hair. I'm giving y'all a class. Please share this and tell somebody about it. And look, so right here is where we get into our actual long length hair. So we're gonna go on the other side and determine where that is, right? So lifting this up, finger combing, we don't need to go in crazy. Look, baby hair bust out already. Do we need to touch that? I don't think so, because y'all love the baby hairs. So I'm gonna put a little clip on that, you know, and I'm gonna start right in front of that. Now I'm gonna do this as best as I can to show you, but if you really can't see it and you really, really wanna learn, sign up to my class like Ventilation 101 at wigsbyddavis.com. What you do first is you comb out the section. We wanna have a section that's about, so from the second knuckle to the base of the finger, that's about as wide as you want your section. Anything wider than that is gonna be way too much and out of your control. Okay, so we're gonna go in and I'm gonna take a little bit more off. I like the less, the better. the less the better, really thin, fine sections. Taking a rat tail comb or something of this sort underneath, right? And then you see all of that hair start to stick out, and I go back and forth and with a finger motion, pull those hairs out, pull those hairs out. Watch this. And bam, Shaquita and Tyrone, get that out of y'all head. Get that out of y'all head. Like, stop that. Ugh. So what you do is you take your shears. Important that you understand the type of lace you have, because at this point you can really damage a wig. At this point you can literally, especially if you don't have a ventilator, you can cut a plug into your wig. So the point is to make sure that you get as close as you can, but also make sure that you're not cutting any other hair besides the short hairs that are separated in that hand over there. Can you see that? That's all I got for you. I can't give you nothing else. Y'all ain't about to get a 3D view. You about to get what you got and be blessed about it, okay? And be on with your merry little ways. Okay, so that's our first section. All right, I'm gonna give you one more for the good old Lord's sake, okay? So let me just give you a thin section. Remember, as thin as possible. Make sure that it's really thin. The most thin section is going to give you the most accurate cut when you go in to get rid of the return. Look, okay, so I probably did a couple things and didn't tell y'all. So I'm going to slow it down one more again. My final time, I promise you. I ain't even going to give you another time. If you don't get it after this, you ain't got it, because I got to move on. Okay, so finger under. Find the returns on the hair shaft. A lot of y'all probably got them really bad wigs, so the returns all the way down here. That's terrible. That's just awful. You might want to throw that wig away or just cut her in the bob and call it a day. But look, if you got the returns and they down here, go there where the returns are, a little bit past it, and then start to wrap. But then go down, if you got longer returns, go down to wherever the returns are, and that's where you're going to start to wrap. So for me, I got a good Asian wig, okay? I'm going to go ahead in and put my finger under there, wrap it around, right? Twist it, holding it in that finger, putting the comb underneath at the root first, and you see how I just fold the hair down, and I'm just, ooh, you can already see it. It's lifting to separate. The short hairs are trying to, like, come out. So I'm just going back and forth, and back and forth, back and forth, and you see they just start springing out. So I like to go in, because it's a lot of them that won't come all the way out, so you need to go in and give them a little tug with your finger. Get in there and remember, pivot that shear. Don't you go in there and just drop, oh, bop, bop, bop. You're gonna be mad about it, sis. Okay, go in with a little pivot on that thing. Start with a, use the inside of your shear. You don't want to be cutting all the way down here. Who told y'all that? Not for this. So using the inside of the shear. Bop, 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 bop. Wig game changed forever. Forever, ever. And ever, ever? Forever, ever. The main thing is understanding that having the returns cut or to a minimum is always going to give you the most realistic movement in the parting, for your styling, for everything that you do. So there you have it. I hope you learned something today. I'm excited to see what you can do. Make sure that you are tagging me on Instagram. And if you want more information about the fundamentals of wig making, go to wigsbyddavis.com and sign up to learn how you can master the art of the indispensable trade of wig making. Start your journey today. I will see you on the other side. And remember, be a good human.